Now, how is Agent Blazkowicz?
A little beat up, sir, but nothing too serious. They've just finished with him in debriefing.
Well, he certainly came through for us this time. Remarkable. Absolutely remarkable. Advanced weapons, biological engineering, robotics, and the occult. It all fits. Into what, exactly? I'm not sure, but it all fits.
I was thinking along those same lines, sir.
Jack, call a meeting.
Yes, sir.
What have you got there, Jack?
Two Dakota dispatches just in from Ultra. The first one is a complete itinerary for Reichsfuhrer SS Heinrich Himmler, covering the next 48 hours. Now wait till you see the next one. A private communique from one Wilhelm Strasse, alias Deathshead, to the same Reichsfuhrer SS, dated yesterday. Shall I read it?
Please.
My dear Reichsfuhrer SS, as you are no doubt already aware, my X-labs lie in complete ruin. Operation Ubersoldat, my life's work, is now a bitter memory. I realize you still have faith in the ultimate success of Operation Resurrection. I wish I could share your confidence. But I feel you have been misled by individuals whose mental competence must be called into question. I leave you now with a word of caution. The Allies have sent a most determined and capable agent to disrupt your ceremony. Do not make the mistake of underestimating him, as I did. Yours faithfully, SS Oberfuhrer Wilhelm Strasse.
Comments, gentlemen?
Sir, may I speak freely?
By all means.
I have to confess, I'm having a hard time taking this seriously. I mean, are we really supposed to believe that all this has transpired so the Nazis can, I don't know, summon the spirit of a thousand-year-old prince? To do what? Win the war for them?
Now wait just a minute.
Please, Jack, let me finish. Now, on top of that, we have what amounts to their own top scientists telling them they've all collectively blown a head gasket. What further evidence do we need?
Sir, it just occurred to me that we may be looking at this the wrong way. I mean, well, if these blokes are really intent upon squandering precious time and resources on all this mystic mumbo-jumbo, well, then...
Go on.
What I mean to say is, if they're dead set upon sabotaging their own war effort, why should we try to stop them?
Jack, I'm sure you have something to add.
Yes, sir, I do. Gentlemen, if just 2 weeks ago someone had mentioned legions of undead, man-made monsters, and demons from hell, would any of you have taken them seriously? Of course not. And neither would I. But think of all we've learned since then. Now you're saying we should ignore the rest of it because, why, it's too incredible? I'm not saying I believe it. I'm saying we can't afford to dismiss it. Once again, it's your call, sir.
It's settled then. Blazkowicz returns to Castle Wolfenstein.
South-southeast. Conditions good. Prepare for jump in 2 minutes.
Hey, can you open the gate, Bitter? I have an important delivery. I'm sorry, this road is closed. What do you mean, closed? It can't be closed. This is the only road into Paderborn. I know, that's why it's closed. Due to special conditions of security pertaining to the upcoming ceremony, absolutely no traffic is to be allowed in or out of the vicinity of the village of Paderborn for the next 24 hours, by order of General von Stauff. But this delivery is for General von Stauff. It's 6 cases of cheese and sausages for the officer's kitchen. Get him on the phone now, I'm sure he'll make an exception. Sorry, we are completely blacked out. What? Due to special conditions of security pertaining to the upcoming ceremony, absolutely no radio communications will be allowed in or out of the vicinity of the village of Paderborn for the next 24 hours by order... Yeah, I know, by order of General von Stauff. Look, I'm not going to be held responsible for this. I absolutely refuse to budge from this spot until you let me through. Suit yourself, but you'll be staying here until tomorrow. But what am I supposed to do with all this cheese? I don't know. Look for some crackers?
Okay, what's happening, everybody? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more Return to Castle Wolfenstein, Mission 6, Return Engagement. Part 1, Bramburg Dam. Alright, so, yes. BJ has now been sent to put an end to Operation Resurrection. And, yes, there's going to be a ceremony which will be, conducted by Marianna Blavatsky that will be taking place near Chateau Schufstaffel in the village of Paderborn. And that will involve resurrecting Heinrich I. So we need to put a stop to that. But for right now, we will have to get across the Bramburg Dam and locate the road to the village of Paderborn. So let's go. Let's get out the snooper rifle. And we'll zoom in right here. And we'll get rid of that guy. Sweet. Alright, so we'll make our way down this way here. And we'll just jump on over. We'll sneak past the delivery guy. We'll head on down this way. Yeah, nobody should see us as we make our way down here. I do gotta say, though, I love the atmosphere of this level. I love the night sky. I love the waterfall. I mean, I know it's kind of weird to be talking about the atmosphere when, you know, we're going around killing Nazis and stuff, but yeah, I like it. Really cool. So, anywho, let's head down this way here. And we will head through this door. We're gonna have a couple guys talking here.
Ah, it's that same damn leak. Well, nothing for us to do but repack the valve.
But we just repacked it last week.
That's right, and now we're going to repack it this week. If we have to, we'll repack it again next week. See how it works?
But it doesn't make any sense. Obviously, we need to order a new valve.
Yes, it was obvious 6 months ago when I put in the requisition. And it's obvious now that we'll be lucky if we get it before 1947. So why don't you stop wasting time and hand me that sprocket?
All right. But I still say it doesn't make sense.
Oh, it makes perfect sense. Haven't you heard? There's a war on.
Okay, so, you don't have to let these guys finish talking if you don't want to. You can take them out silently, and then, the guy in the background right there won't come out of his room, and you can just get him with the, Sten, if you like. But, we're gonna go ahead and get rid of this guy like this. So let's get rid of him first. I don't even know if I got him. Actually, wait, yeah, I did, because I just heard his body fall. But, yep, and they're all suspicious. So we'll get rid of both of them. We'll go in here, and we have one more guy. He is way up there. So let's get him like that. All right. And here he comes. Yeah. All right, so we'll send the elevator up. And I always like doing this here. Yep. I just don't know why that is just so like funny to me. But yeah, the tank just goes flying, and usually it doesn't jib that guy, but, yep, he's nothing but barbecue now. Anyway, let's see, that door down there does not open. Yeah, we need to get our first secret, which is in that room there. So, yeah, we're gonna have to call this elevator back down anyway. Let's go ahead and break through here. Crouch through the little tunnel thing, and we'll pop up through here, and we can grab ammo and armor. And that's that. That was our first secret. Here comes the elevator. The elevator! And we shall reactivate it and head on up. This part always reminds me of the first level of Star Wars Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2, and I know I've made so many comparisons to Dark Forces 2 in this LP, but yeah, like, it just reminds me of the platforms that Kyle rides in the very first level at Nar Shaddaa. But anyway, let's head over this way and we'll open up that and we will pop that guy in the back of the head, and we're gonna have two guys that should come running over. Should be a guy running right there. Oh, I thought he saw me. There should be one more guy. Maybe? Where the heck is he? Oh, there he is. Let's get rid of him with the MG-42. Yep, that's the end of him. And we can take out the delivery guy in the back, too. Alright. So yes, that is everyone. And we'll just go ahead and collect these guys' weapons. And if we head back this way... Oh yes, once again. Love, love, love the night sky. It's so cool to just look out right there. But anyway. Let's get out the flamethrower, because we haven't given the flamethrower a whole lot of screen time. We haven't used it since Mission 4. So let's head on in here and light these guys on up here. Yes, burn and die. Alright, we'll take their weapons, get some food and some beer stein for stamina. You can head up into that tower there, but there's nothing really up there at all. Yes. Let me just go back in here real quick and grab this helmet. And now we can make our way across the dam. So we're going to run over here, and I'm going to crouch behind these sandbags here. We're going to have two guys that are going to come out of that door there, and I think this is the easiest way of getting rid of them, because they won't see you if you're crouched back here. Alright, that's the end of both of them. You can head up into this tower, and you can grab this guy's rifle. This was the first guy we took out way down there with the snooper rifle. Yeah, it's not very hard to be stealthy in this place. Yeah, those doors don't open from this side, they will from the other side, but the room that they lead to isn't really all that useful, I don't think. I've also forgotten to mention, the guys that I took out over there, you can actually take them out from the beginning with the snooper rifle. Sometimes the base gets alerted and other times not, since they, you know, see dead bodies or whatever. Sounds like Hitler giving a speech. Well, yeah, we don't want to listen to Hitler give speeches right now. Yeah, that doesn't usually happen. Usually it's the Horst Vessel theme playing on the radio right there. But yeah, you can just take out those guys with the Sten or the knife. I just wanted to use the silencer. So let's get out the Sten once again here. Now, if the base was alerted, well, as soon as we get to the other end of the vents here, if the base was alerted, there would be a guy with a Panzerfaust right here, and he would try to blow you up with his rockets. But fortunately, that is not the case. You can get rid of these two guys like this. And I'm just going to head around this way here. And open this on up. All right. As long as this guy isn't facing me, then we're good. And then we're gonna have a paratrooper right there. All right, take his rifle. And in this room here, we have grenades and more armor. Now, this room back down here, down there, those are the doors that lead back out to the dam. Those are the ones that I said were locked earlier. And, really, there's nothing down there except for two health packs on the wall right there. So, I'm not gonna go down there, but at least you know what's down there if you need health. And there should be... There may be... Okay. Oh, wait, here he is. I was about to say, usually there's a paratrooper that always comes up right there. Alright, so that's the end of him. And, now we can be loud. Now we can use our paratroop rifle. Take out this guy and wreak havoc out here. Blow that up there. Oop, he got away. He doesn't usually get away like that. Alright. Is there anybody else in that little shack there? No. Alright, and we have this guy here. And that's the end of him. He thought he was gonna be slick by hiding under the stairs, but obviously that did not work. So yes, this is the very end. We have triggered no alarms. Everyone is dead. And yes, there is the road to Paderborn. I don't know what that says. I was gonna try and read what that said, but obviously that is not in English. Anyway, yes, cold food, armor. We can open up the gate. And Paderborn is that-a-way. So, let's head on down. So when we come back, I will see you all in Mission 6 Part 2, Paderborn Village. Till then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I will catch you later.